Today, I thought it will be very important to speak about autism because in my last 37 years of practice, I am seeing more and more children with autism or autism spectrum disorder, or also many children with ADHD, attention deficit disorder, with hyperactivity and poor concentration. So there are a range of disorders that I see children suffering. When we were children, we hardly went to doctor. I think probably in my life, say first 15 years, probably I just went two or three times to a medical doctor, because they were, children were not getting sick. And if we had measles or mumps or something that, you know, if we have it and other children also have it, we will remain in isolation and we will have maybe some pustules on our body, and in about few days it all heals and we get our immunity. This is how childhood illnesses were treated, and we thought that all children should go through this so that the immunity develops. And so it was not seen to be a very big thing, and we passed, and maybe once in a while some diarrhea or cold and cough, but not much. But when I started practicing as a doctor, that was about 37 years ago, I started seeing children more and more sick. The pediatricians have now a lot more work to do, and pediatricians were the busiest doctors. And there is a very long queue, you know, of patients in the pediatrics clinic. So what I see, and I ended up also then helping many children as my patients, and the commonest problem would be every month there is cold and cough and fever, and then we have to give a round of antibiotics, and then they are better for 3 weeks, and again the next round start, you know. And again, we have to do it. Then after 3, 4, 5 rounds, they are very tired. And then they start looking for various natural therapies. That's when I get to see them. And then I used to just help them build up their immune system completely. And they are completely out of these repeated episodes of cold and cough or diarrhea, vomiting. And I had many children also for teething problem, or, you know, teething diarrhea. And all those were much easier to treat. But now, like, we started also seeing the autistic children, cerebral palsy also, but more also autistic and spectrum disorders and hyperactivity. Over the years, we see more and more. And here in this part of the world, we did not hear this autism 30 or 35 years ago so common, but now it's becoming more and more. And suddenly, like, people from, you know, very simple middle class families, they hear for the first time the word, your child is autistic. Or they'll just wonder, what is autistic? What is wrong with my child? So usually the history is like this, that up to 6 months of age, everything was looking normal. The child had eye contact and was very playful, responding, hearing well, and very connecting. And then some things happened after that. Maybe the child got fever, and maybe it was treated with some antibiotics or something. And later on, the child was not responding to stimuli, not talking, not identifying. If you call out the name, they will just not connect, not respond. Then they wait it out for a while, and then they go to a pediatrician, and then the first suspicion that maybe this child is, you know, having developmental disorder, delays in developmental milestone. And that's where then they are sent to the specialist to finally get the diagnosis of autism. And then parents are very shocked. What is autism? How come my child? What have I done wrong? What could I would have done? Very, very hard. And in these days of internet, of course, all of them, you know, start going on Google and ask the Google Guruji all about what is autism. They read, and then they're very depressed, and, you know, it's just like one child, two parents, and lots of work to do. And to help this special child is very, very a big job for the family. So not going into the causes of why this happens, I would just like to say that how we treat with flower remedies, this issue is very deep, very hard. What I also understand that the energy field of the child is very fragile, not developed. These children, when you call them out, they do not identify themselves as their name or who they are, or their grounding or their incarnation or birthing is not complete. And therefore, they are not able to relate. They are not able to identify. They are always living in their own world. They don't understand your instructions. They don't respond to some of the emotions. It's kind of very hard for parents. So there's a child in the house, but you call out, the child doesn't listen. It's really like living in the body, growing, eating, but not having an independent existence. That I am so and so. We would say, show your eyes, show your ears, show your mouth, and then you say, what's your name? Or you show who is. They will have to show like they don't. So, and then there are many other spectrum disorders. There are some children who are hyperactive. So some of the flower remedies, just I would like to name them, are like impatience or vervain or chamomile or yarrow, or at times we also use lotus or crab apple. So a series of different flower remedies that I use in these patients, and we try to heal them energetically in their energy field through the flower remedies, and then they start responding to the environment, to their name, to start taking the instruction, and gradually start learning. So there are, over the years, I have several children who have got flower remedies and have done exceptionally well. Exceptionally well means I can't express that, how they have moved towards a much, much better life. So today, actually, I was waiting for a patient's father to come and share a story with us, but he's very busy probably, so he can't come. Maybe I'll request him to send a video. And before that, today, I have posted a video of a father of a baby girl in Hindi, and it's been only 4 months since they've been treated with us, and there's tremendous change in the child, and he's describing it in Hindi, how they have now more hopes about their daughter. So it's amazing to hear parents every fortnight coming and telling us what more she is doing, what more is happening in her life, and we feel very, very happy, very satisfied. So this is the way to go forward. Flower remedies are very gentle, natural, no side effects. You can take it along with any other pathies or any therapies that child is already given, or a child is taken to a pediatrician or a developmental psychologist or those who are handling special children. Also, I know there are some special schools for them, and the Anthroposophy also has some of the nice schools where they help them with the sensory stimuli and coordination. So all these things can happen simultaneously, while we can also give support of flower remedies. So good morning, Rachel. Thank you very much for joining once again. Harsha Sheth, you are saying that your grandson is speaking very less at 3 years of age. Some small words only, like dada, dadi, bye bye, like that. Some 20 words only, and he understands everything. And so this is another special problem where only speech is not yet happening the way it should have happened. So yes, sure, flower remedies are great, and I remember in the past when we have given these remedies, the children learn so well, so quickly, and within weeks, parents come and tell us that now they are speaking full sentences. Now they are, now they are non-stop. They speak so much. They ask us so many questions. It's wonderful to see. We don't need to take flower remedies forever. We just give it initially where the healing happens, just for a few weeks or maybe few months, depending on each case, because the from case to case, things differ. For those who have autism diagnosis, and even in that there are mild, moderate and severe cases, it can go on for years, the treatment. Okay, 4, 5, 6 years also we support them, but the transformation is tremendous, tremendous transformation. So that this child that I am treating for last 4 years, he like as a child was never exposed to any music or anything, because they thought the loud noise is affecting him. But later on when we started treating him, he took on to piano playing and music, you know, and he's so good at it. When he hears something, he learns it very quickly, just one time. So these are specially able children, you know, though they have certain other difficulties, they have a lot of talents, and now he plays. So I mean, this is the part that, you know, it brings out the potential from inside. It really gives birth to a child in the fullest way and make his life, you know, worthwhile, fulfilling. I mean, parents feel very, very satisfied when they see this kind of growth happening. So Arvinder Lamba, you are saying that socially they may be in their own world, but they are very intelligent in any particular field. Exactly, this is what I said, that in a particular field like computers or sometimes even mathematics, we do not know which field, but once they find out their calling, they are fantastic. They something that I do, if I hear some piano tune, I will not know what to play. I don't have that ear, but this child has. It's amazing that he will just Google, he will listen to the tunes, and he will just figure out this is how it should be played, or this is the note. Amazing to know. Plus, he's also like, he can speak 3 languages. He's very good in his now academics. He's gradually improving, growing, asserting himself. Really, really good. We see. And there are still some issues left. We are working on it. He had also multiple food allergies, very, very severe allergies. Something like, I mean, I cannot even describe how severe his allergies were. But now only a last one allergy is left. That is the allergy to gram flour, that is chana, chickpeas. So that allergy is still left in his, but all other allergies are gone. He was hardly eating, you know, more varieties of food. Now he's able to eat lots of varieties of food also without any trouble at all. So this is gradually we built up the immune system, we built up the energy field, we try to remove the blocks or where the things have gone wrong. Exactly, in the first years of life, for 6 months also, there's a possibility that something was also not right at intrauterine life that needs to be paid attention. We also do that with the flower remedies for the 9 months in the baby's womb. If the mother suffered or mother had stress, the baby's energy field is generally very weak and the very fragile or very vulnerable. So then later on in life, they succumb to it even faster. So of course, these are all part of taking the treatment and healing the patient. Each person is treated individually from case to case separately. First, I take a full history of the patient, including they bring in the file, they tell me developmental delay noticed at what time, what age, what happened to the teething, also the vaccination history, any allopathic medications also taken, any other diseases that are suffered. I just want to know what is also there in their genetic tree of the family. So all these things are taken into consideration, and then the flower remedies are selected. And every month we, you know, decide whether the same to continue or to add something new. And this is how gradually, you know, we build up the system. And the most beautiful part is that nature has this secret. In nature are these beautiful flowers, you know, that are having tremendous healing energy, and it helps us mentally, emotionally and physically in all the 3 levels. So we can take it, whichever program is, you know, we need to install into our own system. We can take it from the flowers and the leaves and the bark and the root and the fruits and the gemstones. All these can be taken into the energy form, into the liquid bottles, or you can also take it in the sugar tablets, and you just have to keep taking. So we are the microcosm of the macrocosm, and if something is missing, we can always look out into the macrocosm and start building up, and we can start rewriting our life and history all over again. So these children have a great possibility. We can support them while all other pathies are going on. Any other developmental delays or hyperactivity or lack of focus or concentration or just fearfulness or fear of staying alone and sleeping alone in a room, or academically if they are not able to comprehend a particular subject, like say just the maths is a problem and all other subjects are good, still we can help and see whatever is optimum possible for that child. It's not that I'm saying that the children become super intelligent or 100% normal or something like that, but we can still bring out the optimum potential in these children. This is what I want to say. And this is what I've been doing for all these years. So thank you very much for listening to me. And if you have any other topics in mind, if you want me to speak, I will be very happy. Thank you, Rachel, for always encouraging me. And I'm happy to share. Arvinder is asking me that autism is a result of certain. Now, this is a hypothesis. I suspect that some children are very sensitive and they might not take vaccination that well. This is just only a hypothesis. More work needs to be done on this subject. When the data is out, then we will be able to say which particular vaccine or which additive that was added in the vaccine is directly causing this. Because see, when the 100 children are given, maybe some children develop some side effects. So we do not know. I think it is the individual response that differs, and that could be the reason, one of the reason, but it's only a hypothesis. So I would not like to kind of comment anything more than that. What we do is that we straight away want to help the children with the remedies, and we find that it is very deep acting. All the flower remedies are very deep acting, and they work quite deep into the system, into the mind and into the emotions and the energy field and the meridians. So we are more interested in the results finally. So although of course if we know the cause, it also helps a lot more. If there is not a link to gut health and bacteria and highly toxic bodies, now the thing is that the environment gets created for the bacteria. And so many of these autistic children are on a dairy-free and a gluten-free diet, and that helps them also a lot, I know. So it's all simultaneous. You also get this in your gut, create an environment where all these unhealthy pathogens are thriving. And so we have to change the environment, and automatically it has a huge impact on the child. Yes, definitely. And I definitely recommend this and help them, because I myself follow a plant-based lifestyle. So I know how beneficial they are. And there's a huge improvement in their performance, in their behavior, everything. So yes, gut health is very, very important. As I said, get them onto the plant-based diet for sure. What else is there? Flowers are pure and giving. Yes, of course, this is what I'm saying. Anyone else? Yeah, what about dyslexia? So dyslexia is when they are not able to comprehend, they are not able to write, or they write like mirror image and many other such things. So yes, they are very quickly helped with flower remedies, very, very nicely. Don't have to take it for very long. The problem corrects very fast. And these children now, I know, I have treated over the years quite a few and have become very intelligent. And I can never forget, because I also remember the diagnosis, the flowers that I gave them and how it changed their life in just few months. And now they are on their own completely. So yeah, it's fun. Flowers are, I'm very fortunate to be able to pursue this branch of healing. And they are very deeply transformative. Provided we give them the help at the right time, it is better. If it's late, we can still help, but it's better to bring them early. And so dyslexia, much, much easier to help. I mean, and also learning disabilities, any of those also can be helped. Slow learners also can be helped. Anything else? Anybody? Yeah, please. So there is a formula, that learning disability formula is there. It is there on my website for dyslexia. Have a look at it. We also have a testimonial on our blog of a child's mother, I think. You can have a look at it, and if you have any other questions, I will help you out. You can always, you're most welcome to send the history, and then I'll probably be able to help you better. So all I want to say that the flower remedies have tremendous power. I'm using them. They are very safe, easy to use. Do open your minds to this system of healing, and maybe, you know, worth trying it out. And as I said, all other pathies or therapies can continue while we just add on this, and just watch for transformation. All right. Thank you very much. Namaste. Tomorrow I'll be back again with another interesting topic. There's a testimonial today I just posted on my wall. It's of a father whose daughter we are treating. If you understand Hindi, do listen to him. Thank you very much.